In this video, let's talk about named ranges in Excel and Google Sheets. Let's do a basic example here. Let's say I have a few numbers, and if I wanted to get the total of these, I would go here and do something like sum, open parentheses, and then select this range. Then I can close parentheses, hit enter, I'm gonna get my total. So that's one way of doing this. Now, what I could do instead of using this regular ranges like B4 through B6, I could go here, select this range, and go to this box up here. This is what we call a name box. Let me just zoom out here so you can see how this looks. So we have this name box up here, and basically we named this range. So I'm gonna call this, for example, coffee. I'm gonna type the name, hit enter. Now I got a new name called coffee, which means I should be able to do sum and then type the range, C called coffee, and it's gonna show up. And if I hit enter, that gives me the total. So that same name box that I did right here is available in Excel too, exactly in the same spot right here. See, you select your range, you go click here, type the name, hit enter, you get exactly the same result. Now, what's also nice about named ranges is that this name coffee is now available across this entire file. So I could create new tabs down here, and from any tab, I could do equal sum and then the name coffee, like so, hit enter, and I would be getting that same total. So this name coffee is now available across this entire file right here. So something you want to remember about these named ranges, if I go back, is that at some point you may decide you want to expand the range instead of having these three cells in the range. Maybe you want to add a couple of more down here, right? So if you wanted to change that coffee to include these two in it, one thing you cannot do is just select like this, type coffee, and hit enter. So it's not going to allow you to overwrite existing names. I already have a named range called coffee, so now I couldn't use that same name for a new range. So you have two options here. You either have to give it a different name or you have to change the existing one. So to give it a new name, obviously that's gonna be pretty straightforward. You would just select all of these, go up in this box, and just type any other name. I could just call this like coffee 2 or something. And by the way, you cannot have spaces or special characters. You could have underscores in this names. So see, now it's called coffee 2. I could go here and change this to coffee 2, which will include those new numbers. But if I want to change that existing coffee name, then what I would do, I would go to this data, and here under data, we have named ranges. And this is where you would basically find that particular name, click edit, and modify this range. So this is where you can modify it, or if you don't want to keep it, you can click on this trash and delete it. Now in Excel, the way you're gonna find those names, if I go back to this, once you select something and you name this coffee up here, it's gonna be all the same way. You would have to go back and modify the range, and you would find it under this formulas tab up here under this name manager. So if I click on this name manager, that's gonna give me the names that exist. And if you wanted to delete it, you delete it here, or you click edit and change the range to a different range. I'm gonna cancel this. So one other thing I wanna mention here, when you work with some files that other people made, you probably don't know what names they've used in their spreadsheets or if they use any at all. So for that reason, what you're going to do here, see, right here, this is the name manager. So using this name box, we could basically just go and type, for example, A5 and hit enter and see how it takes me to that cell A5. And I could also just type that name coffee and hit enter and see how it highlights that range coffee. But what I can also do, if I click on this dropdown, it's gonna show me what are your existing names that are available in this particular file. And you can see that in this file, I got coffee and I got coffee too. Now, you could click at any one of these. So for example, just to give you an example, if I'm on this tab and I go to this dropdown and click on this name coffee, you'll see it will take me to the right sheet here and it will highlight the range. So it basically shows me what that name coffee is. Or if I go to coffee 2, see, I can see what it is. And it works exactly the same way in Excel. You would open this dropdown. Now in Excel, I only did one. So you can see that particular name appears here in this list, coffee. And if you selected something else, you open this and hit coffee, it will select it for you and basically just display what that actual named range is. So if you're wondering what that name refers to, you can always open this box, click on the name, and you'll find out what it is. Now, one other thing I'm gonna mention is that with named ranges, you can name a particular range, like when you select a range, it could be like a range like this, it could be just a few cells like that. You could also name a range as a column. So you could click on this whole column C and name the range up here. Hit enter, and now you got this column named. And it will refer to it as a column. So if I go to my formulas and name manager, you'll see that this my range, what it refers to is this entire column C. So it doesn't go from C1 through C, I don't know, whatever. It just refers to column C. So the same thing you could do in Google Sheets. You can just click on the whole column or the whole row for that matter as well, or multiple rows, multiple columns. This works just fine. Another thing to know about named ranges is that named ranges basically create something similar to an absolute reference. So what that means is that if you use that name in your formula and you drag it down, that range is not going to move. So for example, this formula, if I just go back here and do a regular sum and point to this range with a regular reference like this, if I start dragging this formula down, you'll see how that range will move with every row to the next row below. But if I drag down this one, which has this name, then it's not going to move. So we basically keep referring to the same name, which ends up being the same range. So essentially, that becomes similar to when you select this range and do F4 or add dollar signs to make it absolute reference. And when you drag this down, it remains the same in all of these formulas. That's what you end up getting. Now, so far, all of this was exactly the same in Excel and Google Sheets. But what's also interesting about these named ranges is that you can use them from different files as well. And this is the part that's going to be a little different between Excel and Google Sheets, just because the way you refer to other files in Excel and Google Sheets is a little different. So for example, let's say I have this file. Let me just enter a couple of numbers here. And if I just go ahead and highlight this and name this range, I'm just going to call this Apple. That's the name of this particular range. So now if I wanted to point to this range, if I open another file, so regularly, if I go here and do something like equal sum, I could then go to this file, select this, close parentheses, all here in the formula bar and hit enter. And if I open this formula, you'll see what this says. So this refers to book one being the name of this other file. And if that file was closed, this would be the drive or the SharePoint, wherever you're linking to, the full path to the file. And then we got exclamation sign and then the name of the range. Notice that this doesn't give me the name of the tab, even though this tab is called sheet one. We just have the name of the range itself called Apple. So we could point to that Apple range from a different file too, but we need to make sure that we have a reference to the file before that, and there is an exclamation separator between those. And that's pretty straightforward. So in Excel, you could literally just hit equals, do sum, open parentheses, go to the other file, select it, and it automatically picks up that name called Apple for me. Now let's try to do the same sort of thing in Google Sheets. So I'm going to go back to Google Sheets. So this range right here, let's name this again. I'm going to call it Apple just to show you the similarities and differences between Excel and Google Sheets. So now this is called apple, which means from this file, I could do some apple and that would work just fine, right? But now I want to do this from a different file. So I'm going to go to a different file. And to be able to refer to anything from a different file in Google Sheets, we have to use import range formula. Now, this is going to ask us for URL for the range. So I'm going to do in quotes, the ID or the link to the other spreadsheet. So I'm going to go here, copy this URL and paste it here. And that needs to be in quotes from both sides. You can do either the whole link or just this ID right here. I'm going to give this just a link for now, comma. And then we need the range as a string. So I'm going to open parentheses. And then in parentheses here, let's just enter apple, which is the name of the range. So I'm going to hit enter. Now, because we're linking to a different file, we need to allow access and verify that we actually have access to that spreadsheet. Otherwise, we could have linked to anything, right? And you can see I'm already pulling the range like this with this name apple. And now we can just go ahead and do sum around this whole thing and close parentheses and hit enter. And you can see I got that total from the other file using this named range. And again, I want you to pay attention to the fact that I did not have to use the name of the sheet. So even though the tab here is called sheet one, because that apple range name refers to a named range across the whole file, we don't need the name of the tab. We simply just refer to the name itself called apple, and it knows what it refers to. And that's how we can refer to named ranges from other files as well. So as you can see, that works just fine, no problem. If you like my content, make sure to like and comment, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.